Salatu ve selamu aleyke ya Seyyidi ya Resulallah ve ala alika ve ashabika ya Habiballah. Ladies and gentlemen, I am here to express the dignity and eminence of Ali Bakr Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Some of my companions compelled me to give the lecture about the Ali Bakr Rasul. So I did one of the verses of the Holy Quran, which is not completed, but it is a part of verse. Quran says, "Kul, O my Holy Prophet, say the people, La as'alukum, I am not going to ask anything. Alayhi ajran means about the preaching of Islam, about the working day and night, for the prosperity of Islam. And I have saved you from the hell, and I enable you the paradise. I'm not going to ask any remuneration for these struggles, but I am just asking you illa al-muwaddata fil qurba. So you are duty bound to love my family al-qurba. My family, there is no word meaning my, but here ya is ya muhafza al qurba means, in fact it was al qurba means my family, and ya was omitted and it was replaced by the al qurba. This is called ya taweez, means it means that you are asked to love my family. Here Imam Nasfi writes in his book Tafsir Madarik, he reports Hazrat Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu to have asked Nabi Kareem alayhi salatu wasalam, man qurabatu ka haula illadhina wajabat alayna muddatuhum ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam, ya Rasulullah, let me know the names of those your relatives whose love is compulsory for us. So this question shows that he already knew that the love for the family of the Prophet was compulsory and obligatory. But there was a question who they were, because the word of Qurba was confused. It has got many meanings. When a language is spoken, the language terminologies and their civilization is also utilized. Here, Qurba is a word which is used for the wives as well, for the children as well, for the cognate cousins as well, and for the servants working at home are also called Alul Bayt. Therefore, it was to be differentiated by Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that who were the persons who were obligatory to be loved. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Al-Hasanu wal-Husainu wa Abawahuma. The love of Hasanain Kareemain. Imam Hasan is one, the second one is Imam Husain, and their mother Sayyida Fatima, and their father, Hazrat Ali Murtaza Sher-e Khuda, may Allah be pleased with him. These are the persons whose love is obligatory. Imam Fakhruddin Nazi was reported to have written in his book Tafsir Kabir. He says that the relatives of the Prophet are equally shareholder with Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam in love. Love of the Prophet is also compulsory, and love of Ali Bayt Rasul is also compulsory. This verse shows that the love for the family of the Prophet is obligatory one. It is not optional. It is not only sunnah, but it is sunnah as well and compulsory and obligatory as well. All of the Muslims who recites Kalima Sharif is duty bound to love Ahle Bayt Rasul Sazam. The equal type of love is necessary for the Muslims. The love of the Holy Prophet and love of the family of the Prophet. As shirking the work in the love of Nabi Kareem Sazam. Similarly, the shirking the work in the love of the relatives of the Holy Prophet is also highly culpable action. One would be penalized for negligence in this matter. And the second thing, the Ahle Bayt Rasul are equally shareholder with Nabi Kareem Sallallahu in salam. Salamun alal mursaleen. This is the proof of salam for Nabi Kareem Sallallahu. Salamun ala Ilyasin. According to the recitation of Hazrat Abdullah bin Masood, he writes, O Salamun ala Ali Yasin, means the all of the Prophet are also deserving person to be saluted at be saluted at them. So this is equality of right in Islam as well. And the third one is the charity of zakat is unlawful for Nabi Kareem Sallallahu. Similarly, charity of zakat is charity, obligatory charity is unlawful for Ahle Bayt Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And the fifth one is the sharing in the one fifth of booty. Means when there is a war between Muslims and non-Muslims, and the non-Muslims are conjugated, and the plundering is obtained by the Muslims, that is distributed among the tacticians, among the fighters, and one fifth of the total booty is distributed among Ahle Bayt Rasul. They are shareholder, as Nabi Kareem is also shareholder in the one fifth of the total booty. Ahle Bayt Rasul are also equally deserving person to be granted the one fifth of the total booty. So these five things are there, which are equally shared between Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and between Ahle Bayt Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Salat and salam and love and prohibition of charity of zakat and deservation of one fifth of the total booty. So here Imam Shafi radiallahu ta'ala was reported, Ya Ala Bayt Rasulullah, Hubbukum Fardun Min Allah Fil Quran Anzalahu. O family of the Prophet, your love was obligated by Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. It was necessitated. No one is exempted from this liability. All of the Muslims who have recited the Kalima Sharif from Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala up to the last Muslims, all of them are duty bound to love the Holy Prophet's family. And especially these five persons are necessary to be loved. And these are the persons whose name was used as virtue for the pardon of Hazrat Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Imam Fakhruddin Razi writes in his book, Ad-Durrul Mansur, this is a book of transmissive exegesis. The exegesis are two types. One is technicals, when all of the Islamic normative sciences are utilized and applied to derive the meaning of the text of the Holy Quran. And the other one is transmissive exegesis, as the text of the Holy Quran was communicated by Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to all members of Ummah. Similarly, the words of the traditions of Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was also recorded. This type of is called transmissive exegesis, means the Quran was commented on by the tradition. Those traditions and the text of the Holy Quran combinedly are transmissive exegesis. So in transmissive exegesis, Ad-Durrul Mansur Imam Fakhruddin Ali writes in the book Durr-e Mansoor that when Adam Aleyhissalatu Vesselam was expelled from the paradise along with his wife, and their dresses were withdrawn, and all of the bounties and facilities granted to them by Allah Subhanahu wa Taala inside of paradise, all of them was deprived, all of them was withdrawn, and they were deprived of all of the bounties of Allah which were granted to them in paradise. But when they were thrown on the earth, Adam Aleyhissalatu Vesselam was thrown in Colombo on the mountain which is called Adam Mountain. The Adam Mountain has got very valuable stones, gems. The valuable stones are called gems. The best gems and more valuable gems in the world are those which are found in the mountain of Adam. And my Hawa, my Eve, was thrown in Jeddah, near about more or less 300 years. They were wandering here and there in search of each other, but they could not reach each other. Or ultimately, Adam Aleyhissalatu Vesselam used the virtue of Ali Bayt Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He requested Allah, "Oh my Allah, forgive my sin, oh my Lord, by virtue of those persons whose lightings were shining underneath the throne of Allah." Allah asked him how he found out the lights and their background. He said, "When you inflated the soul in my body, and I firstly glanced at the lights, five lights hanging down from the throne of Allah, I asked what they were." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him that they were five persons who were created, for whom you were also created. If they had not been there, I would not have created you. It means that all of the universe, along with the prophets, along with the awliyaullah, along with the lights, along with the ocean, along with the mountains and the greeneries, the meadows, everything was created just for sake of them. Then he requested Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive his negligence. So Allah forgave him. So it means that the first sin or weakness was repaired or pardoned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by means of Paitan Pak, the five persons who are termed in Islam as Paitan Pak. Means these five persons are purely sanctified and purified. Look, Nabi Kareem was the foundation stone of Ahl Bayt Rasul. When he was born, there was perfume in all of the atmosphere, and there was light inside and outside. Noor andar noor bahir kucha kucha noor hai par kayon kaiye ke sab duniya ki duniya noor hai. And my Shifa, the mother of Abdurrahman ibn Auf, said when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam came out of our mother's womb, I put my hand to take him, and there was no filth, no impurity. He was completely sanctified. He was purely purified. So it means that the first member of Ali Bayt Rasul was Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was ideologically pure as well and physically pure as well. There was no internal or external impurity on his body or in his belief. As a belief, he was completely pure, and as an evidence, he was found purified from all of the filth, and there was perfume everywhere. Everybody was smelling the perfume until Abu Jahl, when came in the morning to collect the consecrations inside of Kaaba Sharif, he found the perfume. He said to himself that such a perfume was never found in his past life. What is this like? So he could not understand. But after that, he resulted, he logically inferred that really that was on account of birth of Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. This was the first purified person, Panj Tan Pak, five bodies. We were sanctified and purified by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by birth. This is not on the account of their character, not on account of any other contribution, but it was God gifted. They were born purified and sanctified. And the second was Hazrat Sayyida Khatun Jannat. When Khatun Jannat was born, there was no filth, no putrefaction. Putrefaction means the blood which comes out after the birth of a baby. But there was no sign of that blood. Hazrat Sayyida did not miss any prayer. Just immediately, Janabi Sayyida took bath and offered the prayer. And there was no sign of any impurities. In the time of Imam Hassan and Imam Hussain, both of them were reported to have been born purified and sanctified. And the fifth one was Hazrat Karar. He was born inside of Kaaba Sharif. Imam Devi, Shahulullah Sahib Mahdi Devi, writes in his book Izalatul Khafa and Khilafatul Khulafa, volume number 4, in the chapter of Maasre Hadre Karar, the deeds of Maasre deeds and adventures of Hazrat Hadre Karar. He writes that the birth of Mawla Murtada Asad of line of Allah was is an admitted fact, and Hakim Bani Hadith Tawattur Nakal Kardast means Imam Hakim says, Imam Hakim is very extensive scholars. When he is compared with the other traditionists, no one is there to be compared with him in respect of his struggle, his knowledge. He wrote the book on the jurisprudence of hadith as well. No book was written by Imam Bukhari on the jurisprudence of tradition. But Imam Hakim was a very big person. He writes that this hadith is continuous, means it was continuously approved by different type of scholars, and everybody believes that it was fact that Hazrat Ali Murtaza Sherif Khuda Radhiyallahu Anhu was born inside of Kaaba. But no report says that the Kaaba was impure, or the dug of or the mud of the Kaaba Sharif was dug out and thrown outside, because there was no filth, no impurity. There is no question of digging the mud or dust of Kaaba Sharif. So these five references shows that Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was also born purified, sanctified. Khatun Jannat was also born purified and sanctified. Asanan Kareeman were reported to have been born sanctified and purified, and their father Hazrat Ali Murtaza was reported to have been born inside of Kaaba Sharif, and no filth or impurity was found there. So this is enough proof to substantiate the purity of these five persons. Panj, Tan, Pak, Dhir are five in number, and the circumstantial evidence were found there, which is totally impartial. The circumstantial evidence is totally impartial. Nobody was there to take interest. These references are totally impartial, which substantiated the purity of these five persons. And the virtue of Imam Hasan, Imam Hussain, Khatibullah Jannat Maulamza, and Sayyid Anbiya Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So this is enough to substantiate the preferability and seniority and eminence and majlisness of Ali Bayt Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And this was the beginning of their life, the end of their life. Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was asked, Ya Rasulullah, let us know why you ask all of the followers to ask a favor for you after just after the promulgation of Azan.
Yeah.
When an announcer announced Azan, you ask them, as soon as listen the finishing of Azan, they should ask Allah Rabb hadhihi ad-da'wah ad-da'umati wa salawat al-qa'imati ati Muhammadin al-wasila. Oh my Allah, please give the status of wasila to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What is this wasila and what and why you ask all of the followers? He said, because this is beneficial for all of the followers and favorite to me as well. That is a palace inside of Kaaba, inside of paradise. The companion asked whether somebody will live there. He said, I myself will be living there. And that is the noblest area and the noblest place in the universe. No palace can be compared with that one in respect of nobility and dignity, very dignified and dignitary palace. They asked whether somebody will live there or not. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I shall live there. That is my residence. That is my residential palace. Then they asked whether somebody will live with you or not. He said, Hasan Hussain, Khatun, Jannat Maula Muta, these five persons would live with me and no one else would live with us. It means that which I mentioned in the beginning, that was the beginning of their life, Poindra Park, and this was the end of Poindra Park. And look, on the judgment day, all of the communities would be there, the followers of the previous prophet as well, and the followers of our prophet's followers as well, companion, the caliphs, the 10 persons who will be given the glad tidings of paradise in the life. And Hazreen Badr, the persons who participated in the battle of Badr Sharif, and Hazreen Uhud, these are also very dignified person. Just after Ashraf Mushra, the Badriyin are preferable to everybody. And after Badriyin, the Hazreen Uhud, the persons who participated in Uhud Sharif, that were very tough type war, because 70 persons were killed at the spot, and near about 70 persons were badly injured, and Nabi Kareem Rasulullah was also injured. These are on both places superior to everybody in the Islamic world. When the Muslim Ummah is superior to everybody as compared with the previous Ummah, and this is the classification of the companion of the Holy Prophet. And then the Hazreen-e-Ahzab, the persons who participated in the war of Ahzab, they are very preferable persons, but no one of them could be compared with Ali Bayt Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is reported to have said, أَوَّلُ مَنْ أَشْفَرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ مِنْ أُمَّتِي آلُ بَيْتِ. This reference was quoted by Allah, the Father, Ibn Ali, Rahmatullah, in the volume of Fatawa, 23, page number 232, Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was reported to have said, Hazur Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, Ashwalu Yawm Qiyamati Ummati Ahlul Bayti. The first parties or first group, I intercede them with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is Ahlul Bayt Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, my family, the point and park. And after that, summa al-Quraysh, fal-akrab, min al-Quraysh. Then, stepwise, the nearest Qurayshi people would be interceded by me with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then, man amana wa tabani min alil yaman. Then I intercede the Arab people. And in between, he said, the Nasirin, Ansar, the Ansar would be interceded by me with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then, man amana bi wa tabani min alil yaman. And on fourth stage, I shall intercede the Yemenite people who believed in me and then followed me. And after that, summa sair al-Arab, then the rest of Arab, I shall intercede them with Allah. And after that, summa jamil muslimin. But awal man ashfalhu yawm al-qiyamah, afdal, the party and the community, I intercede them with Allah, would be more preferable than everybody in the world. It means, according to this tradition, was also substantiated that the Ali Rasul were preferable to everybody in this world and in the next world. This is why Shah Abdul Aqsa Mohammad Delhi Ramtullah writes in the book Takmilul Iman, page number 41, that all of the attributes and the qualities and dignities and the eminences explained about the other companions or other personalities are with the exception of Ahlul Bayt Rasulullah. And he referred and he quoted the reference of Qasida Amaliya. He writes, the Mujtahideen, the juristical scholars of Qasida Amaliya, have detailed the fact that all of the qualities mentioned about the other companions and followers of Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they are with the exception of Ali Bayt Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and no one is there to be compared with Ali Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala explained, he said, Urkubu Muhammadan fi Ali Baytihi. O Muslims, you are duty bound to consider the dignity and the personality of Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam while behaving towards his Ali Bayt Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And Hazrat Sayyida Fatima, after the decision of Fadak Sharif, she fell ill and confined inside of the house. Then Adibu Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala found out that she was annoyed with her, with him. He went there. Adibu Ali Sharif Khuda radiallahu was out of the door. He met with him and asked him, please give me the permission to talk to Janab Sayyida Fatima. He said, I cannot give the permission without previous permission of Sayyida Fatima. Adibu Sayyida Fatima was asked about the permission for Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala to have a conversation with you. Then Sayyida said, you should attempt all of the further observation precautions and you should manage properly, and then he should be allowed to come inside and talk to me. He came inside after the permission and sat aside and began to talk. He said, Sayyida, I don't find any virtue in my life. La ajadu khairan fi maishatin aishuha wa anti alayya sakita. O Sayyida Fatima, I don't find any virtue or any goodness in my life when I see that you are not happy with me. It means that when he was leading the five prayer in the mosque of Rasul-e-Kareem and he was attending the court and deciding the cases according to Kitabullah and Sunnat-e-Rasulullah, and he was doing the tahajjud as well, and he was doing the extra devotion as well. So why he said, I la ajidu khairan fi ma'ishatan aisha abanti alayya sahab, because you are annoyed with me, then I don't feel that any virtue can be found in the prayer or tahajjud or attending the court or deciding the cases according to Kitabullah and Sunnat-e-Rasulullah. I'm thinking that all of these are going astray because you are annoyed with me. It means that the annoyance of Ali Baitul Rasulullah, according to his belief, was really a destruction of the devotion and worshipping. Then, Vandi Ali, because of the annoyance of Janabi Sayyidah, displeasure of Sayyidah, Fatima was cancelled, or cancelling all of the virtues. Then he said, Ante Talamina, you know that Nano Tharakna Ala Wal Aulada Wal Azwaja Wal Amwala Illa Ibtiga Wajhi Rabbillah and Ibtigai Mardatillah Wa Ibtigai Mardati Rasulillah Wa Ibtigaikum Ya Ala Baita Rasulillah. You know that we have forsook all of the wealth, properties, movable, immovable, and wives and children, and all of the belonging of our life, we forsook them just because of sake of pleasure of Allah and pleasure of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and pleasure of Ali Bayt Rasulullah. It means that the migration of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu was not just for the pleasure of Allah, just for pleasure of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but pleasure of Ali Bayt Rasulullah was also included in his belief in the. He was doctrinated by Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this way. He was conceptuated according to this, as he has expressed. It means that the prayer of Ali Bayt Rasulullah is also a source of acceptance of the devotion and worshipping and doing the goodness. Everything is in need of approval by Ali Bayt Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Hazrat Abu Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala said, on the judgment day, there will be monopoly of Hazrat Hadri Karar on the bridge of judgment day, which is called Pul Sirat. He says, La yajuz akhadin sirata illa man azana lahu illa man kataba lahu aliyun lil jawaz. Nobody would be able to pass the bridge of judgment day, whether his companion, caliph, successor, Awliyaullah, Ghaus, Qutb, Qalandar, Darvesh, all of them would be in need of support of Hazrat Ali Murtada Sher-e Khuda. So it means that the Muslim say, Ya Mushkil Kusha, this is the greatest difficulty and problem. And this difficulty would threat all of the human being going on the other side of Pul Sirat, but by the help of Hazrat Ali Sher-e Khuda, unless the passport of the passing through the Pul Sirat would be written by Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, nobody would be able to cross the Pul Sirat. Bridge of Judgment Day could not be crossed without the passport of Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala. This is the monopoly of Hazrat Adre Karar, and this status was not granted to anybody, whether they are caliph, the caliph or the successor or decessor or predecessor, anybody, they were all of them in need of Hazrat Ali Sheikh Khuda radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And in Abi Sayyid Aisha was reported, he says that Aliyun Kasibul Jannat wa Nar, distribution of paradise and the hell, it was handed over to Hazrat Ali Murtaza Sharif Khuda radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So this is a great status. And Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu came one day to visit the shrine of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ja Abu Bakr li ziyarat qabr Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam ba'da wisalihi bi sittat ayyam, after 6 days of the burial of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abu Siddiq radiallahu was reported to have come there to visit the shrine of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he came there, Hazrat Ali Sheikh Khuda radiallahu anhu respected them and said, please be in front. Taqaddam ya khalifat rasulillah, O caliph of the holy prophet, please go ahead. He said, lastu lam akun li an ataqaddama rajulan samitu rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam aliyum minni bimadrati inda rabbi. I am not ready to overtake the person who was reported in my presence by Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Hazrat Ali Murtaza Sheikh Khuda radiallahu ta'ala, dignity wise in front of me is with the same position as I am in front of my Allah. Means as there is no any obstacle between me and my Allah, and there is no spiral progress there. I am direct to Allah, and Allah and me are adjacent. Similarly, Ali Murtaza Sheikh Khuda radiallahu ta'ala is not apart from me. He is adjacent to me. There is no any intervenes of any person. No one is intervening there. Hazrat Ali Sheikh Khuda radiallahu ta'ala adjacent to me. So this was reported by Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Imam Jalaluddin Suyuti rahmatullah ta'ala says under Surah Bayyina, Hazrat Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu ta'ala asked Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who are the people which was mentioned here? Inna alladhina amanu wa amilu salihati ulaika hum khairul bariya. Those people who believed in Allah and did the good actions, hum khairul bariya, those very are the best creature. Who are them? Then Nabi Kareem Rasul said, don't you know that it was mentioned about Hazrat Ali and his followers? Hazrat Ali and his followers are the best creature to Allah, and they will be granted the paradise. And after that, Hazrat Abdullah Ansari, Jabir bin Abdullah Ansari, says that whenever Hazrat Ali Murtaza Sharif Khuda radiyallahu anhu would come in the meeting, in the congregation of the companions, he would announce that Ja Khairul Bariya, this is the person who is the best creature in the world after the prophets. So this was a routine of Muslims, and especially the companion of the Holy Prophet. So thus, one can easily understand that the dignity of Ali Bayt Rasulullah cannot be measured. They were, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I left my followers, but I left none equal to Hazrat Ali Sheikh Khuda radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Means at the time of departure of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, nobody was equivalent towards Dari Sharif Hudarat Allah Ta'ala. So I cannot say, but when Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam himself says, nobody can debar him as well. And Hazrat Abdullah bin Masood was reported for many times. He kunna natahaddasu anna afdal ahli al-madinati Ali ibn Abi Talib. This was our conversational attitude and behavior. We could say that all of the companions who believed in Muhammad Mustafa and followed his religion and are sincere to his mission are better than the total world. Total world cannot collectively cannot be compared with the Medinan people, and all of the Medinan cannot be compared with Hazrat Ali Sher-e Khuda radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Hazrat Ali Sher-e Khuda radiyallahu ta'ala anhu was matchless in Medinan people. So it means that Afzal of Afzal is Afzal. Man is superior of superiors is superior. So dignified of Hazrat Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu cannot be measured. And this can be detailed by other quotations as well. Hazrat Abdullah bin Masood said in Mujam Kabir by Tabrani, Mujam Osad, or page number 537, he writes there, he says that Hazrat Anata Allam Tal Quran Sabi'ina Surat Amirar in Khair al-Anbiya, I studied and I learned 70 verses, 70 surah of the Holy Quran from the person who is the best prophet. No committee of and community of the prophets can be compared with Muhammad Mustafa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He is the best prophet. He is the supreme prophet. The supreme person among the prophets is Muhammad Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I learned 70 surahs from the person who is the best prophet, and I completed and khatamt al-Qur'an in the Khair al-Bashari Ba'd al-Anbiya, and I completed the Holy Quran with a person who is best human after the prophets. So, means the total humanity cannot be compared with Hazrat Ali Sharif Hudaradil. This is not my quotation. Yeah. This is the quotation of the Abdullah ibn Masood, which was mentioned by Tabrani and by the other books as well. They say that Hazrat Abdullah ibn Masood was believing that Ali Murtada Sher-e Khuda radhiyallahu anhu was more preferable as compared with all of the other companions of the Holy Prophet. And Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says that my Fatima, if Fatima is happy, I am happy. If she is annoyed, I am annoyed. Means the annoyance of Sayyida Fatima is a cause of annoyance of Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Ulkubu Muhammadan fi Ali Baitihi. And all of the virtue can enable the person to get into the paradise. But there is no any guarantee of status. But the love of the Holy Prophet is a status, is a guarantee of status as well. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala reported Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to have caught hold of the arm of Imam Hassan and the arm of Imam Hussain as well, and pulled them to himself and said, Man ahabbani wa ahabba hazan. He so ever loved me, loves me, and loves these two persons, and Abba Umma, and loves their mother and loves their father. He would be not only granted paradise, but he would be granted paradise in the areas which is area of my residence.
SubhanAllah.
Means you can get the paradise by means of prayer, by means of payment of charity of zakat, by the payment of fitrana, by the observation of the fast, by the performing of pilgrimage but you cannot get the area of residence of Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam without love of Ali Bayt Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I studied. I have expressed my ideas here about 55 minutes. So that is enough for you as well. Inshallah, rest of the subjects will be completed afterwards. And tomorrow will be rights and obligations of wives and husbands and other relatives will be discussed, inshallah. And that will be in Urdu, inshallah.